And then the last one is And as I told you, in English we have three levels of us. In your mother tongue you have isn't it? But here we have just, we have three levels, that is and So we have this one. This is the first level, that is This is the shortest, and I think I have given you the name of this symbol. What's the name of the symbol? Shwa. So Shwa means a weak wall. Okay? Yes, exactly. Yes. So that is the shortest. Next is this one. And then we have this one. These are the three levels that we have. All right. Now we'll quickly move on to diphthongs. In fact, if you were all here for the face-to-face program, then we could have had lots to do here. I could have at least seen how each one of you was articulating the sound. Now, I think I gave an introduction to the meaning of diphthongs in the previous class. When you say E, or when you say E, and when you say O, you can feel the tongue moving. But when you just say A, ear, you don't feel the tongue, but you know that there are two different sounds involved here. So ear, your tongue is just gliding from this position to another position. Ear, air, oi. All right. So now you just quickly take a look here. So diphthongs are nothing but vowel glides. They are articulated when the tongue glides. So this is the gliding movement. Okay, the big birds, how do they fly? They just glide. So the tongue glides from one vowel position to another vowel position. Like A, Au, or El. All right. Yes, so during the process of articulation of sounds of a language, the tongue occupies different positions in the mouth. So when it glides from one vowel position to another vowel position, it forms a vowel glide. Glides, the other name is called a diphthong, and there are eight diphthongs in English. Now quickly take a look at this. So all these three sounds end with E, E, E. All right? A, I, oi. Now say, repeat after me, bay. I'll just enlarge this. Bay, date, day, rate, main. And whenever there is some influence of mother tongue, then these sounds get affected. So main road, many people say main road, main road. So it's not main road, it is main road. Next we have I, buy, tie, die, ride, mine. See, this is mine, but this is main. And when you write the transcription, this looks like main. Have you noticed this? So in the transcription, the slanting lines, it looks like main, but the pronunciation is mine, I. And this is A, main. And now for this one, oi. Oi, boy, toy, toy, voice. Now this particular sound, there's a strong influence of Malayalam. So many people are not able to say this oil, they say oil. So oi becomes oi. And here, the other part of South India, especially Karnataka or maybe Andhra, I'm not sure about the other states, but our own state here, the Kannada speakers and the Urdu speakers, because this oi is not there, they tend to say I'll. Haven't you observed that? So I'll, when you go to the petrol pump, they say I'll haki. You put pour some more oil. So instead of oil, they say it as I'll. So we have to make, we have to make a conscious effort to pronounce these sounds. Oil, boy, tie, koi, voice. Yes, Anuradha?
Yeah. Even among us, when we converse among ourselves, there is a difference in the pronunciation of the language. For example, Kerala teachers, their accent is a bit different from ours. Is it because of the influence of their local language or
identity? Where are you from, Anuradha?
I'm from AP, ma'am.
AP. Okay, so AP also, because AP is our neighbor, no? So yeah, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, all our neighbors
from. Yeah, ma'am. When a Kerala teacher is speaking, we can easily identify the teacher is from Shia. He's from Kerala. Yeah, why is it so?
There's a mother tongue influence because they're so used to saying that word. The sound. So, oi comes very easily for Malayalam speakers. Isn't it? All the Kerala participants, what do you say? So, this sound is
yes,
very
ma'am.
Natural. Yes, Anu?
Yes, ma'am.
But at times, certain conscious efforts are also doing that.
Yes, definitely. So, consciously when you're putting it, even in Karnataka, see this oil is oil. Not there. In Urdu, now I'm a Urdu speaker. But and many of our Urdu fellow men, they say, I can hear, make out. But when they're putting in a lot of effort, this ah becomes oh. Got it? So because it's not there in our mother tongue, we tend to use whatever is freely available in our mother tongue. That's all. But conscious speakers will not do that. Okay? And here also,
we have a problem with making use of r sound, ma'am. So mother, brother, sister.
Yeah. So, brother. And your l also. You have three l's and you tend to use the second and the third l in English. So apple becomes apple.
So we make a conscious effort to make our children pronounce it properly.
Exactly. And here also, Tamil influence is here for this particular sound, A. Instead of saying parents, many people say parents. We will come to the next one, where the Tamil influence is there.
No.
Okay. Now look at this. This is a very stylish sound in English. Oh. Oh. We don't say no, it's no. Please say that no. So, row, bow. And here we have ow, cow, now, how, bow. So, when you see here, we have B-O-W here and B-O-W here also. But this is bow, the bow and arrow that you have. Okay, you tie a bow with your shoelace, you tie a bow with your ribbon. All right. And this is a bow and this is an arrow. Whereas this is a bow. How do you greet your elders? With respect. You bend. So that bending is taking a bow. So bow. This is bow. So next time when you come across this word, you should know how to pronounce it contextually. We'll be having a test also later on at the end of the session, end of the month. But I'll make sure that I will not ask you these kind of confusing words. Even if it is asked, you should be able to find it out from the sentence, okay, or in the context. Either the verb or the noun form will be mentioned or the sentence will be mentioned. So from that, you should be able to pick out and make out what sound it makes. So she tied a dash with a shoelace. She tied a bow. And this is bow. She bowed down, or he bowed the realness. All right. Now we have the next one. Ear. Ear, ua, ear. Beer. No, it is not beer. This one is not beer. It is beer. Here. Dear. Dear. So this also, many people confuse with this. These two are homophones, you know. This, they are similar sounding words, homophones. It is not deer, it is deer. And this is ua. This also many people say, poor thing. There isn't poor thing, this poor, cure, tour, sure. Till now, many of you were going on tour and saying poor. So it is not tour and poor, it is tour and poor. I'm going on a tour. So next time you tell your principals that you want to take your children on an educational tour, even if they don't understand, you will have to continue saying tour. Okay? Next we have air. Yes, this is the sound I was saying. The Tamil accent is very strong here. The Tamil influence. The air, bear, it's not bear, care, chair, okay? It is bear, care, chair, dare, how dare you? Now we have one bear here and the other bear that side. You notice that? See? You have one bear here. And you have another bear here, B-A-R-E. Okay, I'll write with the other one. B-A-R-E. So this is how you need to find out. All these similar sounding words. Now this also is a homophone. Bear and bear. One is the animal bear, the teddy bear, and this one is bear, bare hands. There's nothing in my hand, so it's bear, barefooted. All right, so bear and bear, and we have deer and deer, and we also have T-E-A-R. This also has two different pronunciations. See here. When I put it here, it is tear. The tear is that you have in your eyes. And when I put it here, it is tear. You tear the book, tear the paper. You understood? So tear, tear. These are words which have the same pronunciation but different spellings. And here, this is a set of words which has same spelling but different sounds. Okay. So with this, we have learned all the 8 diphthongs. I'll quickly take you to the general slide here. Now this contains all the 8. A, I, oi, o, au, ear, ua, air. Okay, so with this you have learned all the 44 sounds, and now you need to just take a picture of this exercise. Identify the diphthongs represented by the letter or letters underlined in the following words and write the phonemic symbols in the space provided. Okay, Rajesh Kumar, which one do you want to repeat now? So there are 15 words where you have to just underline, I mean, write the symbols for the underlying letters. And now, a bigger exercise, Now that you've learned all the 44 sounds, you are going to write the transcription of the full word. I hope you know how to write the transcription. Yes? Okay. Now, for example, if you have, yes, if you have the word C-A-T, cat, this is badly written.
Car and mat.
Yes. Ah. So if this is C A T cat, yeah, quickly try to write in a notebook. If all of us are writing it correctly, write the transcription for cat in your notebook. Because here you won't be able to do. Curve. And then you write A.
Iron Man.
And then you will write
Ta.
Ta, yeah. With here the marker, it I have to only use one finger to keep drawing the line. So the handwriting is a bit bad. So this is how you write the complete transcription. Cat. Okay. Yes. Now in your final, the post-test, you'll be having a similar pattern of exam what you did in the pre-test. Words will be given, letters will be underlined. Chinnarao, please mute. Yes. The words will be given, letters will be underlined. You have to pick which symbol is correct here for that particular underlined letters. Yes, Ashalata. Yeah, this is how you learn. Now, most of you are learning it for the first time. You have to keep writing. Okay, try this first. That's why it started off initially with only the consonant sound, then only the vowel sounds, then the diphthongs, and then later on for the entire word. So this is how it comes. Go with very simple ones. And later on also, you start a notebook. Now that you've learned all the 44 sounds, you can start off. So one side, you just go on writing all the words here. All right. And then whenever you're free, you take a pencil and keep trying out whether the symbol is correct or not. And later on, look up the dictionary. Then keep doing that. You will definitely learn. Okay. This is about the 44 sounds. Yes, Rajesh Kumar wanted a repetition for all the 8 ones. I'll do that quickly. Fine. Now this is A, I, OI. I hope it's visible. Next we have O, OW, EAR, UA, AIR. So till now, whatever we learned, it was at the phonemic level, that is the segmental features. But now let us move on to something beyond that, and that is called the suprasegmental features. The other name for suprasegmental is prosodic. You must have come across this, all those who have learned phonetics earlier, you must have come across this word in some of your books. Prosodic features are nothing but the suprasegmental features. Now, what comes under suprasegmental features? Yes, can you tell me what are the words or what components come under this? At the sound level, it is only the phonemes, okay? So that is the segmental features. But going beyond, if I say, I know how to say, Mr. Suryaprakash, my question is, beyond the segmental features, now till now you learned the 44 sounds. So if I say I know this language, that means I should know how to use it in sentences, okay? So there are different things that are involved in speaking. Now what are those things?
Stress, madam. Stress on it.
Yes. Then?
Intonation.
Intonation. Yes. Somebody else? Good.
Accent. Tone, madam.
Tone. Okay. The tone. Yeah, that is what I think Mr. Surya Prakash has written here, rise and fall. So you should be specific, rise and fall of what?
Tone.
The tone. Okay, so fall and rise of the tone. All right, now pause is very important. We give pause at the right place. Now, for example, if I say, yes, stress and intonation. What she said was right. Now, how many different ways can you say that? Or I'll give you another one. Who said Tommy?
Two types.
Yes, two types. What is that, Sridevi?
One is commanding, madam. One is questioning, raising. Okay. Madam?
So, who said Tommy? You can write in two different ways. Yes. Who? Put a question mark. Said Tommy. Who said
interrogative?
Yes. All right. Fine. So the pauses are very important. So unless you know where to pause, you will not be able to utter correctly, and the listener will also not be able to understand what you're saying. Okay. Now we'll just take a quick look at these things, because before you understand stress, this part, you should know the meanings of. Yes, kill him, spare, not spare him. Kill him, not spare him. Good. Now we'll stop at pause. Okay, we'll proceed to stress.
Hang him not.
Yes, hang that's him what not. I said. Hang him not, kill him. Hang him not, spare him. Whatever it is. Hang him not. Leave him. Free him. Okay, now prefix, suffix, affix, syllable. You need to understand these terms. Give an example for prefix.
Unbelievable, ma'am.
Illiterate. Untouchable.
Illiterate. That comes before the word is prefix. An example.
Unhappy.
Illiterate.
Suffix. Suffix.
Suffix.
Transformation. Transformation.
Delightful. Okay.
Childish.
Good. Good. Next, affix. What do you mean by affix?
That we don't know.
What is affix?
That we don't know, madam.
Anybody else?
Prefixes and suffixes together.
Something which we kept in.
Very good. Who said that?
For example, encouragement is an affix.
Anup. Okay, Anup. Good. So both, yes, Mary Celine, you are also right. So prefix and suffix together are called affixes. Okay. So what I have written here is applicable to both. An affix could be a suffix, an affix could be a prefix. Both. So prefix and suffix together form an affix. Then coming to the main thing is the syllable. Now quickly tell me what you understand by the term syllable.
Syllable is a minimal speech sound.
Minimal speech sound is a phoneme.
Minimal of a word, madam, along with one vowel.
Minimal sound of the
vowel.
Anumati said that there is a vowel count. So, this syllable is nothing but the smallest part of a word where
sound unit.
Where the nucleus is a vowel sound. See what I've written here. A syllable is a unit of pronunciation of a word consisting of either a vowel sound alone or a vowel and one or more consonant sounds. It is the smallest part of a word where the nucleus is a vowel sound. So a word should a syllable should definitely have a vowel sound. Now, how do we decide how many vowels are, how many syllables are there in a word? Now, for example, my name, Usma. So when I utter my name, it has U and A. Usma. Now, you all try to say your own names, mute, and then say how many syllables you have.
I have three, madam.
Okay.
Three. I have four syllables.
Nirupam has got four.
Three syllables.
See, A itself is a syllable. All right. Because it is one vowel sound. Okay. Adam Shafi. A. Dam. Sha.
Two.
Three.
Prakash.
We have four.
I have four.
Shekhar.
I have Shri four. Lata.
Shri.
I have three.
La.
La.
Ta. Now, when we are uttering these, we don't take the spelling into consideration. Now, Shri Lata has E, double E. All right. But we are not looking at the spelling. We are just going by the sound. And now, all of you just keep your hand, the fingers just below your chin, and say some word. Now, for example, computer. Now, you see how many times your lower jaw keeps moving. Yeah, stop typing, all of you. Do this exercise.
Three.
Yeah. Say computer. All of you do this and say computer. Computer. So, three times it went on. Computer. Isn't it? So, this word has got three syllables. So, this way you can teach your children. Now let us take a quick look at this word, cat. Phonemes are three, right? Yeah, put Raju, please mute. Okay, phonemes are three. We have the k, then a, and then t. But in one breath, we just say cat. It is just one syllable. Next, take a look at car.
One syllable, madam. One.
Car. This also one. Has got only one. Now, cartoon. We have A and
two.
U. See, we have A.
Two
syllables.
So,
we have two syllables.
Now, for this, when you add a suffix to cartoon,
Three syllables. We are not looking at the spellings. Please listen.
We are not looking at the spellings. When you see the spelling, we have A. Okay. So we've got A here. And we've got U here. Double O. But when you're uttering the sound, it's just A and U. So this is one. And this is also one. Okay. You want me to... Okay, is this clear now? Fine. So, cat, car, cartoon, cartoonist. This is how we do. Now, what do we call a word with one syllable?
Monosyllabic.
Yes. So this is a monosyllabic word. This is also monosyllabic, disyllabic, polysyllabic. Yes. Three or more, we call them polysyllabic words. Okay. Now we'll take a quick look at the different types of stresses that we have. We have word stress and sentence stress. In a word stress, we try to stress on syllable. Now you all know the meaning of syllable. And in the sentence stress, we stress on particular syllables in a word. We don't stress on all the syllables in a word. Now if you say a sentence, I don't want to go to school. I don't want to go to school. or I love to go to school. I love to go to school. I got a new computer. So we don't stress on all the syllables in computer. What did you buy in the market? Or what did you buy yesterday? I bought a computer. So computer. We don't stress on all the syllables. It is just one. Okay. See, when it comes to a monosyllabic word, it is very easy because you just write the word. Now that is my cat. And you just
put a... Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, how can we know where to stress?
Yeah, and that is what I'm telling you now. I'm going to teach you that now, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. See, this is a monosyllabic word. This is absolutely no problem. This is a small vertical line. So just before the word, we try to mark the stress. That's a cat, not a dog. Now the problem begins when the word has many syllables. Now we'll first take one at a time. Disyllabic words. This ago, about, again. I told you already, this all these are schwas. Okay? So schwa cannot take a stress. That you must have noticed. So the stress automatically falls on the next syllable. So whenever you come across a schwa sound, make sure that you are not stressing it. So we pronounce it as ago. We don't say ago, about, again. Ago. Please repeat. Ago. 1 year ago. About. Roundabout. Again. Please come again. Then below. Beside. Behind. All this B, 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 B. We don't utter on that. I mean, we don't stress on those B's. Then we have reduce. We don't say reduce. Recite. Receive. No, receive. We don't say, I received a prize. I received a prize. Prize. Okay, you say the screen is not clear. Is it okay now, Krishna Rao?
It's clear. It's clear.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, please repeat. Ago, about, again, below,
beside,
behind, reduce, recite, receive. Yes. Now this is about a disyllabic word. Okay. Now there are some words disyllabic where the stress changes within the word. If it is a noun, it is different. If it is a verb, it is different. Finding a lot of such examples in the dictionary. Random, you just open some dictionary, you will get one word having different meanings and different pronunciations. Okay? So please repeat now. Content. Content. Project.
Project.
Not project. Project.
Project.
Conduct. Conduct. Transfer.
Transfer.
Transfer. Object.
Objects. Object.
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 Say up.
Object.
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 This is this is object and this is object.
Madam, the difference may be in long sound and short sound?
Yes, yes, exactly. Here the sound is long. This is a strong sound, you say. Not long. This is a strong form.
Strong.
This is aw. Okay. Whereas here it becomes shwa. Object. Similarly here, content, content, project, conduct, conduct. Now this is transfer, object. Okay, good observation. You will have to find more such words which belong to these different categories. All right. And then we have words which do not undergo any change in the pronunciation, whether it is a noun or a verb or an adjective. Example, award. Now you can just recall how many meanings of award are there. I got an award. I was awarded. Okay? And then account. How many accounts do you know? You have a Facebook account, email account, and then on account of
bank account,
account book. So you have a noun, you have an adjective. Yes, alarm. Yeah, we don't say alarm. There is no rum here. It is only
alarm.
R is silent.
Alarm.
Arrest, we don't say arrest.
Arrest.
Advance.
Arrest. Advance.
Bandage. Balance. Okay. So when you notice here, these are all schwa sounds. That's why no change at all.
It is account or, ma'am, is it account?
Account.
Account.
Yes. It is not account, it's account. And you must have noticed here, when there are two similar letters, we try to have a division of syllable here in between them.
Announce.
Yeah. Look at this. Announce also, yes. Account.
Okay.
We quickly take a look at the policy networks. One second, because we need to catch up with a lot of things. The polysyllabic words. Communication. Now the last syllable that we have, it is called the ultimate syllable. So how many syllables in communication?
Five.
And the last one is called the ultimate syllable. The last but one, that is the second last, is called the penultimate. And before the penultimate, third last, we call the anti-penultimate. Okay, so don't say anti, it is anti. Yeah, just repeat,
ultimate, penultimate, anti-penultimate.
Yes. Okay, now, when we know these things, then you should thank you, Star, that there are only names for these, only three. Otherwise, it becomes very difficult to mark the stress here. Okay? Okay, Krishna Rao says the screen is not visible. Is it still a problem, Krishna Rao?
No, ma'am, it's visible. It's visible, madam.
Fine, thank you. Now we'll just take work. Okay, fine. Now it's okay. Now, words ending with I-A-N, I-O-N, I-O-U-S, I-A-L. Now, all these are suffixes. All right?
Yeah.
You'll have to think of a polysyllabic word. Don't think of a short word like Indian. So I want a polysyllabic word which has at least three syllables. Then you will understand how to mark the stress. Someone was asking
companion.
For the words.
Pardon? Companion.
Companion.
Continuous.
See, you need to add a word to the main word. We want a suffix. Now, how will you mark
electrician.
The suffix?
Electrician.
Yeah.
Electrician.
Now, please, wait. Now, please take a look here. Such words take stress on second last or the penultimate syllable. So for that, you need to understand how many syllables are there in this word. Of optician. There are only three. We don't say optician. It is optician. Shin, shin, shin. So now when you say second last syllable, where is the stress? This is one and this is two.
Two.
Yes, so you're marking it here on optician. Now I'll similarly here, communication. We all know communication has got five syllables. And the second last is where? This is the second last. K. So we don't say communication skills. We say dictation. Fictitious. Official. So please repeat after me.
Optician.
Optation. Please say mute and repeat. Okay, we don't want you to disturb others. Yes. Optician.
Optician. Communication. Fictitious.
Mute. All of you mute. Yes. Optician. Communication. Fictitious. Official. Putraju, I can see you typing there. Please don't type when you are supposed to speak. Okay, we are doing some practice here, so you also join. Okay, now the words ending with ity, logy, cal. Where is the stress? This is on the third last syllable. Reality, psychology, psychological. Now I want you to write more words in each category, mark the stress, and learn how to pronounce. You can take a screenshot or you can just jot down here quickly. Similarly, for these kind of words here, for everything, IAN, you divide your page into many columns here and just go on writing all the examples that you come across, either from storybook or newspaper or out of your own memory. Just recall long, long words and then look at this rule and mark the stress. I hope you'll do that, all of you.
Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, quickly.
What about Indian, ma'am? How many syllables it has, ma'am?
It is Indian. Just one, Indian. I mean, Indian. There are two syllables.
Only two, ma'am. Indian.
Indian. Indian.
Not three syllables.
No, we don't say Indian, we say Indian. Indian.
Indian. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, a small doubt.
Quickly.
Yeah, just a while back you said, either a storybook or a newspaper.
Yes.
Either or either. We have a confusion.
Both are correct. You can say either, you can say either you can say.
On the either side of the road.
Yes.
So either is also okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
British and American, they are used interchangeably. Similarly, neither and neither. Leisure. Leisure. Leisurely. Leisurely. That's okay.
Okay, thank you.
Pause and raise. All right. Yes. Next, we'll move to rule number three. So this is how we do this. Reality. Psychology. Psychological, Similarly, if it is zoology, it becomes zoological. Zoology. So the second O, zoology. Then what else do you have? Sociology, sociological, biology, biological, zoology, zoological. All right, so here also you have the strong forms and the weak forms. This is O, psychology, and this is U, psychology. Yes, but when you add a suffix here, any different suffix, then this becomes schwa, psych. So psycho, what you had here, becomes weak as k. So psycho becomes psych. And logy becomes logical. See, this becomes a strong form now. Can you see the interchange? O, a. Here it is a, o. Psychology, psychological. Technology, technological. So this technology word is very, very mispronounced, even psychology. That you will have to correct for yourselves if you're making mistakes, and for the students if they are making any mistake. Okay, so please repeat: reality, psychology, psychological. Next, we have verbs ending with ate, ise, izy, ify. So, how do we pronounce this? Now, the stress falls here on the third last. That is a antepenultimate. Retaliate. Please repeat. Retaliate. Socialize. Minimize. We don't say minimize. Minimize. Personify. And as I told you earlier, please divide your page into many columns like this. Go on writing many examples for each of these category and mark the stress. After marking the stress, try to utter these words. Articulate it correctly. All right. Now we'll just go to another set here. The numbers. Now when the numbers end with teen, the teen gets stressed.
Teen.
So how many numbers can you think of which end with teen? Yes. There are seven. So beginning with 13, we say, we don't say 13, we say 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Okay. Yes. Now I want you to say the words along with me. If one person has written 7, Badriya wrote 7. So it doesn't mean that Kalaimani also has to write. So concentrate on the next part. Okay, I don't want you to miss out. If one person has written the right answer, just leave it off. No problem. Okay, and then so this is how the stress is marked. And then we have suffixes ending with E. We say nominee, trainee, employee. Okay, so the last part gets a stress, E. And then stress in compound words. If there are two nouns, the first noun gets stressed. Postman, tea party. Whereas if you have an adjective or an adverb in the beginning, the noun gets a stress. So we don't say afternoon, afternoon. Vice chancellor. See here, postman, tea party, afternoon, vice chancellor. And then words ending with self and ever. So these get stressed. A self, himself, however, whatever. So this is all about the word stress. Now we'll just take a quick look at the derivatives. Photo, photograph, yeah, photographer, photography, photographic. We don't say photographer has come. The photographer has come. From now onwards, you have to change your pronunciation. Politics, political, politician. Democrat, democracy, democratic. Compete, competition, competent. Okay? So with this, we will stop, but there are some exceptions, as I told you, 13 in isolation. But when you're using it along with another word, we say 13 students. Afternoon in isolation. But when you're using in context, it becomes afternoon session. We have classes in the afternoon session. Okay, now take a screenshot, and this is your homework. I'm giving you lots of homework. Please do it leisurely. And after this, we'll take a short break. You will all log out from this platform, and we'll all meet in Google classrooms. All right.
Madam?
Yes, just quickly.
Okay.
Yes, tell me what.
So is the Google this, group, madam?
Yes, they're the same groups. Group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you had logged on for your article presentation, just log in there. I think Raghavendra sir has posted again. Let us see. Otherwise, if you have it, you remember, you can join. Or I'll ask you.
Just come out and jump into that, madam.
No, don't jump. Just log out. I'll just end the meeting here so that there's no confusion at all. You will open a new link in the Google platform.